everyone, and welcome to my studio. I'm Linda Peterson, and thanks for joining me today. It's time for another Spellbinders Mixed Media Monday video, and I'm going to show you how to create your own stencils using Spellbinders dies, and we're going to add some dimension to your handmade greeting cards. These are the pieces that you'll need to cut using the Artisan X-plorer machine. First, you'll need to cut one house from the Houses 2 die template set from the Spellbinders Media Mixage line. You'll also need some leaves and some branches from the Holly and Twigs die template set, and make sure that you keep your negative image from the branch. And finally, you'll need some flowers from the Cherry Blossoms die template set. Apply some creative medium to a card or a room key and spread it over the stencil. Carefully remove your stencil to reveal the textured branch. Once your paste is dry, apply ink with a cosmetic sponge. To create a shadow and to add some extra depth, I'm also adding an additional layer of brown ink around my card and the branch. And to really highlight that dimension, I'm using a brown permanent marker and going over all of the raised areas. I've decorated my little house and I've applied some dimensional foam dots to the back. I'll position that in place. I'll add my leaves and my branches, and if you notice on my finished piece, the flowers give it a nice decorative touch. Now I've gone a little wild with the paint, but that's okay because in mixed media there are no rules. So have lots of fun and explore beyond.
Now remember, you can use this technique not just on your greeting cards, but also on your art canvases and in your art journals. So be sure to check out the entire line of Spellbinders dies and the Spellbinders Media Mixage line on our website at spellbinderscreativearts.com. Leave us a comment below. We'd love to hear what you think of the video. Be sure to click that like button and be sure to subscribe to our videos because we upload new videos each and every week. Well, that's going to wrap it up for me in the studio, but I'll be back again real soon to share more tips, techniques, and ideas. And remember, the possibilities are endless when you explore beyond.